هيا على الفلاح.
The anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His curse is real. It happens and it comes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes angry. As much as we've learned that He is extremely merciful, the most merciful, there are sometimes certain actions that we engage in that earn the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His anger and His curse and His punishment. And it is important that we realize that the Quran has addressed us as well as all mankind regarding the anger and wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The idea of that is for us to take heed. We must make sure we are not engaged in those type of deeds. We need to realize and understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares His anger against certain people and against certain actions. And that shows already that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has anger, and we may sometimes be engaged in deeds that will earn or ask for the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is referred to as the anger here? They are هُمُ الَّذِينَ عَرَفُوا الْحَقَّ وَتَرَكُوهُ. They are those who knew the truth but left it. That is who is being referred to by those who have earned the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The people of the book as well as all others who have known the truth. They knew what the truth was. They knew that this is what we are waiting for. We are waiting for this sign and that sign. When the messenger came to them with all those signs, they preferred to cover their book and turn it and twist it and hide it. And they preferred not to accept the message solely because of the fact that he was from amongst the Arabs and he was not from amongst them. The same applies to every single one of us. If we know the truth, we know the Quran, we claim to believe it, we claim to accept it, we know the messenger, we know the messengers, we know the revelation, we know the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we then reject it and turn away from it, we will earn the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if Allah is angry with us, believe me, it spells doom for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us about shaitan, the devil, Iblis, the one whom we spoke about. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, be careful. He is the one who is cursed. He is the one whom Allah's anger is upon. Listen to the verse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن يَدْعُونَ إِلَّا شَيْطَانًا مَرِيدًا لَعَنَهُ اللَّهِ. There are those who call out to shaitan. There are those who call out to the devils. Allah says, the devil is cursed and he is the one whom Allah's curse is upon. Let's listen to what else Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention. That verse was in Surah An-Nisa. In Surah Al-Hijr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكَ اللَّعْنَةَ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ. Iblis, for you is the curse of Allah until the day of Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. One might ask that what were the details of what shaitan did in order to earn the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It's important we know it. Because if we engage in the same deed, wallahi, we will be asking for the curse of the Creator Himself. Listen to what Allah says. The deed that shaitan committed was pride and arrogance, haughtiness and ingratitude. He was ungrateful. Allah gave him everything. He still turned away from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him life. Allah gave him his own health in whatever way he has it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him absolutely everything and still he turned away. With us, we have life, we have health, we have time, we have the whole 24-hour day. We have so much goodness, we have food, mashallah, we drink, we eat. But we can't even spend a few minutes for the Creator in salah. Is that fair? Do we then expect goodness or do we expect the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He gives us a day with 24 hours. Then He tells us, I want 24 minutes back from you. Only 24 minutes in the condition of salah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us regular with our 5 salah. Therefore, don't be lazy when it comes to getting up for Salatul Fajr. Don't be lazy when it comes to the other salawat, to fulfill the 5 daily prayers that we have. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gave us 24 hours. He's asking us for 24 minutes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection and understanding. So the quality of Iblis that made him earn the anger, the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was arrogance, haughtiness, ingratitude. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Sad.
قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُ.
This verse seems to be repeating itself. Allah says that Iblis said, I am better than him. I am better than whom? I am better than Adam. May peace be upon him. Adam alayhi salatu was salam. I am better than him in this way, in that way.
خَلَقْتَنِي مِن نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِن طِينٍ.
You have created me with fire. You created him with soil, with dust, with sand. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then expelled Iblis. Alayhi la'natullah. Allah expelled the devil from heaven. And this shows us whenever we engage in haughtiness and pride, we will be expelled from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will take away from us our happiness and our goodness, and he will kick us right out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
أخرج منها فإنك رجيم.
Get out, get straight out of this heaven. There's no place for you in this goodness. You are indeed one who is cursed. You are one who is really astray. You are one who is out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the pelted one. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to pelt shaitan when we go to Mina for Hajj. But the idea is to remove shaitan from our own selves. Shaitan comes and finds within our bloodstream a home. And sometimes he then takes control of us. It's important that we say, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from shaitan, the devil. So Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the same surah, he says,
Wa inna alayka la'nati ila yawmiddin.
You have my curse because of this, because of what you said, because of what you did, because of your arrogance, because of your haughtiness, because you thought you were better than him, because you thought you were better than another creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whom Allah had granted elevation above you. For that reason, you can be cursed and you will have my curse right up to the day of Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never do that to any one of us. That was shaitan and Iblis. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about ingratitude and fighting the messengers of Allah. Those who fight the messengers of Allah have earned the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There were some of the people of the book who used to kill the messengers. Every time a messenger came, they didn't like the message, because they had to change their whole lives in order to adopt what that messenger was coming with. They were used to bad ways and bad habits. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains to us how they killed the anbiya, they killed the messengers, they killed the prophets, they fought them. And for us, do you know how it applies to us? Anyone who is the messenger of the messenger, if we make his life difficult, who are the messengers of messengers? The ulama, those scholars of deen who have studied the religion, they come back to us with knowledge of the messengers, of what the messengers came with. They are known as messengers of the messenger. And this is why it is important that we do not fight them. We do not despise them. We do not disrespect them. They are not prophets. You may find them erring here and there, making a mistake or two. But remember, if we are to disrespect them, we will reduce the value of the scholars of religion. Let me inform you of a plot and a plan of the enemies of Islam that we as Muslims do not realize and we are forwarding. We have ulama within our midst sometimes who at times, because they are not anbiya, they are not prophets, they have a few errors, they may make mistakes here and there, they may need a little bit of correction and rectification, and that applies to every single one of us. But now you have a plan to reduce the respect of the ulama in the eyes of the Muslim masses across the globe. Wallahi, that is a plan. And it is a plot, and I have come with my own eyes, I have read some of these issues that are mentioned by the enemies of Islam within their own findings and researches, and they are following and adopting, and they are succeeding in destroying the Muslim Ummah to a certain degree. When I say destroying the Muslims themselves, drifting them away from Islam. No one can destroy Islam as a religion, but they can easily drift the Muslims away from Islam. May Allah never do that to us. What is happening? Any scholar whose name you utter today, whether in this country or anywhere on the globe, someone somewhere will have something bad to say about them. Do you agree? Yes, it is. It's a fact. I can tell you and I can show it to you. You name me any scholar, whether it is in your community or in your country or in my country or anywhere across the globe.
how shaitan has made us despise our own scholars, those who are supposed to bring religion to us. No one respects any one of them. Name me the top scholars of your country, you will find a large group of people fighting them. This is the plan, this is the plot, and we are sucked into it. Allah says that's the curse of Allah. It is the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One wonders why that is happening to us. We have left the book, we have left the message, and we have left the messengers, and the messengers of the messengers are also from amongst those who are being fought and tackled. When you have a problem, or when you notice a scholar of Islam doing something that is wrong and incorrect, the way to correct it is not to go to the masses and to try and tell the masses this person is useless, because then people will say the same about you, and then the whole community and all the public will have no one to give them guidance. They will get their guidance from the internet. And for your information, the internet is full of websites which are purporting to be Muslim sites, but they subtly have certain messages which will then drift you away from Islam. But let's get back to the most important point. Those who are fighting the messengers and the prophets, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curses them. And let us realize and understand, wallahi, we need to respect the man for his knowledge. If there is an error, we try and correct it. If it is something great that is wrong, completely out of the fold, we may educate others in a respectful manner without despising and respecting. I tell you why. Every scholar of deen, Allah has given them a different ability to get to a different category of people. So if we are to respect all of them and all the different types of activity of this religion, inshallah, we will be able to wholesomely benefit the entire ummah. But when we start despising one group and we start despising those scholars and people who studied here and those who went there, we are forwarding the cause of the enemies of Islam, because it will result in loss of respect of the scholars of Islam amongst the public, and that is happening today. Believe me, I have witnessed it in this country. Very sad days are being witnessed by us in this particular country and across the globe, where true scholars of Islam are being accused of items they are free of. And remember, that is the curse of Allah. That is falling into the clutches of shaitan. It is our duty to utter this. And this is why we have uttered it, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wherever correction needs to happen, and I'm repeating this, it should happen with respect, and it should happen with the dignity of the scholar of deen remaining intact to as far as we can. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who respect all the ulama of this ummah. My dearest listeners, the point I'd like to end with is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah and in many other places in the Quran. In Surah Al-Baqarah, after making mention of his curse and his wrath and anger, he says, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَبَيَّنُوا فَأُولَٰئِكَ أَتُوبُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Those who repent, those who turn, those who make clear, who make amends, Allah says, we will forgive them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most forgiving, most merciful. So today we've heard about the curse of Allah. How many times He's mentioned it in the Quran? Let us realize and understand that really we need to engage in repentance, and let us become conscious of our deeds. If we are engaged in any of the deeds that were mentioned tonight, these are very serious deeds that will be invoking the curse of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and calling it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all and save us from his curse and his anger. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad.